I'm Abhishek Patnaik, and today in this tutorial I'll show you how to extract or download web pages to your computer for offline browsing. Well, to get started, let's start the WinHTTrack software. Let's open it. This is WinHTTrack website copier. Now write your project name, enter a project name that best suits a project you're working on. For example, if you are interested in downloading a site such as C++, you can just write C++ here. And in the project category, it's a tutorial site, so you can write tutorial. And choose a base path, and your project files will be saved under base path. Then a folder with the name of your project name. Then now enter a URL. You can click add URL and enter c++.com. Click OK. Now set options and choose the limits. Maximum external depth to 0, and this one to unlimited, and the maximum connections per seconds will be 10. Then the flow control, choose 8 as the number of connections, and then timeout will be 60 seconds. Click links and then test the validity of all links, and then get the HTML files first. In the build, check no error pages and hide passwords. In the spiders, you do not have to change anything, and in the express too. In the log index, you need to check the store all files and cache, and uncheck create log files, and check make a world database. In the browser ID, you can select the most recent one, and select none for the HTML footer. In the scan rules, this is very important. You must delete these. And now, if you are downloading a site such as C++.com, so you can enter the plus signs, then the C++.com/star.css, then copy the path and write star.js, then the PNG files from the server. This is basically you're implementing the scan rules so that you know what to download, which files to download. You do not need any external images or CSS or JavaScript. So you're basically limiting the resources to the particular site you are downloading from. So one more resources we will be including is the web fonts, and these come in varieties such as SVG, WFF, TIFF, and so TIFF. Well, that's all the extensions you need. Then click OK. Then click Next, and you can select the provider you want to connect to. If you are a dial-up user, you can select to connect to the provider if you already connected. And then check that disconnect when finished. If you do not want to get disconnected, then uncheck it. Or you can also specify a particular time or schedule at which it will start. It uses a 24-hour format for schedule management, and you can specify 2-5. This counts to this 2 o'clock a.m. and click finish so that it will start at 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock to 5. Okay, now I will click in cancel, so cancel it because I don't need it. And okay, quit. So if you go to D drive, then my websites, then you can see this C++, the folder is created with the same name as the project name, and you can simply double click it If you have downloaded, then here there would have been an index file, index.html file. You can just open it to any browser you want. And that's how you download websites. Thank you.